प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी वेर डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ अ वाटर ट्रीटमेंट. वी हैव कवर्ड इट. देन सोर्सेस एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ सरफेस एंड सब सरफेस एंड एंड इट्स सूटेबिलिटी दैट वी हैव स्टडीड. वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज सैम्पलिंग, व्हाट आर द मेथड्स, व्हाट आर द प्रिजर्वेशन टेक्निक, राइट, व्हाट आर द ड्रिंकिंग वाटर क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्ड्स एज पर BIS लिमिट एंड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द water quality parameter. This we have finished. Now in today's class we will be concentrating our study on unit flow diagram, right, along with your intake structure, because your water treatment will be starting from your right from the intake of water from the source we will be starting. So we will cover first, right, regarding intake structure, and then we will go to the unit flow diagram of water treatment. Okay. Now we will see why there is a requirement of water treatment is there. Why there is a requirement of water treatment is there, that we will see it. Okay. So just a minute, we will see rainwater, how it will be there in the rainy season, that we will be seeing. Okay, just a minute. My voice is clear. Voice is clear.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Because I think there is less range is there today. We will see why we require a water treatment first, and then we will be going to the other aspects of water treatment. Okay. Now this is your just a minute. Okay. Now this is your water during your rainy season. This kind of a water you are going to get in the rainy season. You will be getting this quality of water. You can see how the water quality is. You can see that it is having lot of your soil particle in it, right? It is having lot of soil particle in it, right? So we cannot have this quality of water, right? We cannot have this kind of water, right? We cannot drink it, right? As you can see, it is going to have the soil particles in it. It might be having the microbes in it, right? This particular water, we cannot directly drink it. So it makes necessary, right, in order to treat this particular water, in order to remove, right, in order to, we need to remove all kind of the mud particle in it. We need to make it suitable in terms of your physical chemical characteristics, right? Physical, chemical and biological characteristics. We need to make fit this particular water. Now we have already seen what are physical, chemical and the biological characteristics, right? In order to, we also have seen if we want to make the water fit for drinking, right? How the physical, what are the different physical characteristics we make it suitable for? Say we have seen in physical characteristic, color, odor, temperature, turbidity. We have seen desirable limit and permissible limit, right? If we take this particular water, right, it will be sure shot, it will be crossing its desirable and permissible limit. It will not be having the, say it will be having color, odor, right? It will be having different amounts of solids, pH will be not maintained, right? It will be having so many of microbes in it. So we cannot drink this particular water, right? If you want to make this particular water fit for drinking, we need to treat it, right? We need to treat this particular water. Now we will see conventional surface water treatment, what we will be having. Now you know that this quality of water we cannot have. We cannot directly drink without treatment, because it is going to cross all the physical, chemical and biological characteristics. It is sure shot, it is going to cross. So we cannot drink this particular water directly without treatment. So it makes us right? It makes necessary of the water treatment. It makes that the water has to be treated before we are going to drink it, right? So this is why, right, we make this particular water in terms of physical, chemical, and your biological characteristics. We have to make it suitable for drinking. Until and unless we cannot drink this particular water. Now, this is the flow diagram that we are going to follow, right, in case of your water treatment, right? Now, here in the raw water, right, here your raw water, that is this particular raw water directly which is present in the catchment area, right? It will be present, this raw water we are going to have in the catchment area, right? This particular water, if we want to send it to the water treatment plant, this is your water treatment plant. It is going to have screening, coagulation, flocculation, sedimentation, filtration, disinfection, right? Then storage, then distribution. From this point to this point, right? It is your water treatment plant. But before bringing it to the screening, the raw water, we are going to bring it to the first to the before your screening, right? We are going to bring it into the intake structure, right? This is how your intake is of water is going to happen, right? Raw water, you cannot directly send it to the water treatment plant. Without having the intake structure, you cannot send it to the water treatment plant. Now we will see what is an exactly the intake structure will look like, right? Now today we will be seeing what is an intake structure is. Okay, so now before starting of the screening, we will be seeing what is intake structure exactly, how it is going to help us, that we are going to have it. So before screening, we need, if we want to take the water from the catchment area, we need to bring it to the intake structure. We will see how, what is the intake structure is. See, this is what your intake structure is, right? Now this is your catchment area, right? Now directly we cannot directly this quantity, this water, we cannot directly send it to the your treatment plant. First we need to take it up. Just a minute. There is a bit internet problem is there today, bit. Okay, I hope this picture is clear to you. Yes, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is your catchment area, right? This is your catchment area, right? Now if I want to send this particular water, how will I send it? First I will bring this particular water in the intake structure, and then I will be lifting this particular water, whatever has been stored in this particular intake structure. I will be lifting this particular water directly from the source, right? This is your source, and this is your intake structure. And from this particular intake structure, I will be lifting this particular water and I will be sending it to the treatment plant. So, intake structure is going to help you to take the water directly from the source to the treatment plant. It is not the part of your exactly the water treatment, but it is helping you to take the water from the source to your water treatment plant. Okay, here your water treatment doesn't start. Here your intake structure is going to help you to lift the water, right? It is going to help you to lift the water to your water treatment plant. Is it clear? Is it clear? Yes. Is it clear what is your intake structure, how it is helping? Okay, fine. So we will go exactly to the what is intake structure is. We will see what exactly the intake structure is. Okay, now you have seen what is intake structure, right? You have seen what is intake structure. Now we will see how it is going to help us. Okay, now the basic function of intake structure is to help in safely withdrawing the water from the source and then to discharge this to the water treatment plant or to the withdrawal conduit through which the water is going to reach the water treatment plant. Okay, I'll repeat it. This function of intake structure is to help the safe withdrawing of the water from the source to the water treatment plant. Okay, so this is what the exact work of your intake structure is. Okay, this is going to help you to lift the water from the source to the treatment plant. Okay, it is going to constructed at the entrance or the withdrawal pipe, and hence it is going to be protecting it from being clogged by the debris. Okay, now regarding this, I will tell you how we are going to prevent the intake structure from having get clogged by your debris. That we will be seeing when we are going to have our the next slides. Okay, now sometimes from reservoir where gravity flow is possible, the water is directly transmitted through the treatment through the intake structure. Wherever there is a gravity flow is there, then we will be sometimes this intake structure is normally it is going to be fitted with the pump, right? If we want to take the water and if we want to lift it to the higher elevation, normally these intake structure will be fitted with pumps. But if we have a territory in such a way that our water source is at a higher level or higher gradient, and then our treatment plant is at a lower gradient, then the water will be flowing through the gravity. Okay, the gravity flow is not possible, the water entering into the intake structure. We at least at in order to suck from the lower level to the higher level, we need the your pumps. So we will see how where we can have this particular intake structure. Okay, now the site should be near to the treatment plant to reduce the conveyance cost, right? Now the intake your the site selection for intake structure is it should be very near to the treatment plant to reduce the conveyance cost. Okay, if wherever we want to take this water from, say, if you take the Belgaum to, say, your Rakkaskop, or the Rakkaskop is going to, the source of water, and we are going to have the water treatment facility in our Lakshmi Tekdi, right, which is going to be far away from your Rakkaskop. Okay, now here it is always not possible that the your intake structure should be very near to the treatment plant. Okay, so might be in your Rakkaskop might be there is going to have some amount of say your the debris that has to be removed in your near to your intake structure. But all the treatment cannot be possible near to your dam or near to your source itself. Okay, now here the next we will see what is the next. How the site selection should be for the intake structure. Okay, now intake must be located, right? The intake must be located, right, in a purer zone of the source so that the best quality of water is going to be withdrawn from the source to reduce the load on the treatment plant. Now, your intake should not give you too much amount of debris when you are going to collect the water from your source. So it should give you a good quality of water when you are going to withdraw the water from the source. Now, intake must be never be located in the vicinity of the wastewater disposal point. Okay, now intake structure should not be never it should be present in case of your wastewater disposal system. Okay, now it should be located that it is free from the pollution. It should be located such that it is free from pollution, and it should not be very near to your sewage disposal plant, and it should not interfere with any river traffic. Whenever we are going to have say it the your intake structure should not disturb your river traffic. There will be boats will be moving sometimes. Sometimes your fishing boats will be moving. So it should not your intake structure should not affect the navigation channels, right? Which is going to have the movement of the ships. Okay. Now next is your intake must be located at a place from where it can draw water even during the driest period of the year. Now your intake structure should be located in such a way that right it can withdraw the water from the source even during the dry period. Okay, even during the dry period of the year, that is during the driest period during the summer season also, it should take the water. Okay, the intake site should remain easily accessible during the flood and should not get flooded. Okay, now during your rainy season or what will happen, normally your source of water will be getting, it is fully it is going to be fully filled with the water. Now your intake structure, it should not happen that your intake structure will also get submerged into water. Okay, because sometimes pumps and all it will be there, then if the water is going to be get flooded, then the functioning of the pump will be getting affected, and the at a downstream side where the water has to be transported due to the malfunctioning of the pumps, what will happen, the downstream side which requires the water, it is going to be get affected during the flood. So that is the reason why the intake structure should not, never, it should not be located in the floody zone. Okay. The intake should not be located on curve, at least at the sharp curves. It should not be located at the sharp curves. Okay. Now, the type of intake structures we are going to have is simple submerged intake structure, then intake towers, then river intake structures, then canal intake structure, then canal with intakes for sluice ways of the dams. Now, this is what your submerged intake structure. Okay. Now, this is what your submerged intake structure is. Right. In case of your submerged intake structure, it is constructed and it is going to be the constructed, right? It is here. You can see that the river intake structure, your submerged intake structure is going to be constructed over here, right? This is your incline of a stream channel, right? So this is your inclination of your stream channel. And here, your intake pipe should go. It should be fixed with the bar screens, right? Here, as I have told, it should be free from debris. See, here you are exactly, your strainer is going to be located over here. Now, what I am doing over here is, this is your the catchment area, right? And here I have prepared a concrete base with having the cast iron, right? Cast iron linings, right? So here, what I have done is, I have taken this particular intake pipe, right, into your the catchment area where I will get the water during the driest period of the year also, I will get the water. So it is at a low level of your the catchment area. See, this water can be filled till this particular point. So it is present at a lowest point so that I can get the water during the driest period. So it should not even happen in like this also. It should be completely present at the bottom of your say the catchment area, so that entire debris is going to enter into your conduit and the choking problem will be there. So here I have fitted this particular pipe, the intake pipe. I have fitted it with the screens. Okay, now what are these screens? Screens are nothing but it is going to prevent the entry of large floating elements, say for example paper, plastic, the wood particle. So if I have the screen over here, right, it is going to prevent the entry of all the larger floating elements which are there in the your water body. It is going to prevent the entry of all these. So all the say dead animals, paper, plastic, clothes will not be going to enter into this particular point. Okay, now here I'm having the withdrawal conduit, the water will enter from here, and then it is having, right, this is your strainer, right? This is your strainer which is going to lift the water with having the suction pipe. So here it is going to take the water. Now here I have fixed up a pump, right? Now strainer is nothing but again, see, I have removed here the larger floating elements. I have already removed it over here, right? Now here it is, the strainer is going to remove the finer particle which are there in the water, right? So this is going to remove the smaller floating elements which are there in the water, right? Now But there will be some amount of sediment that is again it is going to be get lifted. See here, it is going to remove the larger elements, but some quantity of debris, some quantity of the solid may enter into your in case of your intake structure. Now this strainer is preventing say the entry of the fine suspended particle which are present in your water. But again, there will be the good quantity of say suspended particle. They may enter into your pump. Okay, now here we are having the low lift pump installed at a level above the your high flood level, okay, of the river stream. So here what we are having HFL here we are going to have the pump at a higher flood level, above the higher flood level. So I have told that, right, the pump never it should be located on your flooding zone, else the water treatment it is going to be get affected. Okay, now we call this particular say we call this particular structure as a jack well or the sump well, right? We call this as a jack well or the sump well. Okay, so here what is happening is, see here also we are having water. Here it is also it is going to have water. It is allowing the water to flow into your sump, right? So that whenever you are going to lift the water from the pump, right, always the water should be there in your jack well or the sump well. So this is how I'm maintaining the water quantity in your jack well. Okay, now this is your submerged intake structure. Okay, this is what your submerged intake structure. So this particular intake is going to be located inside your water. So that is the reason why we call it as a submerged intake. Okay, now it is, as I have told, it is a simple concrete block. It is going to be supported. Now it is going to be covered by the screen, as I have told. Now the chances of your siltation, right, it is going to be elevated, right, 2 meter above the lake bed, right? It is going to be located, say, at least 6 feet above your bed or your catchment area, right? So that the entire debris should not enter into your intake structure, and they are cheap and do not obstruct any navigation. Since it is present below water, it is not going to disturb any kind of a navigation. Okay, now they are going to be used widely in the small water supplies, right, which is drawing the water from the streams or lakes having the little change in water level throughout the year. Okay, now it is a limitation is, as you can see, this particular intake structure is located, right, it is going to be located in a say it is completely submerged in water. So cleaning it might become sometimes a bit difficult if you want to take the water. Now we will see intake towers. Okay, now intake towers, again we are going to have two types in it, that is dry intake tower and the wet intake tower. We are going to have the two types in it, that is dry and the wet intake tower. Now we will see what is first the intake tower is. Okay, now this is what your how your intake tower will look like, right? This is how your intake tower will look like. Okay, now we will see what it is. Okay, now intake towers, they are going to be widely used in the large water supply. For a small water supply, we are going to use the submerged intake. For a large water supply schemes, we will be using this particular intake towers. They are widely used on large water supply projects, which is going to help to draw the water from the rivers and reservoirs. Okay, now they are going to have the gates. Now here we can see that it is going to have the gates. Right here we can see that it is going to have the gate. This gate it is going to be operated up and down, and then we can have whenever we are going to have the water requirement, then we can enter into this particular conduit. So it is going to be operated with the help of the gates. Okay, now we will see the gate controlled opening called ports. We call them it as an ports. The gate controlled opening, right, we call them as a ports, are provided at a various levels in these concrete towers, right, in order to regulate the flow. As I have told, the flow inside the intake structure or in the conduit, it is going to be controlled with the help of the gates, right? We call it as a ports. Okay, gate that opening, we call it as a ports. If the entry ports are submerged at all levels, there is no problem of any clogging or damage, right? Even if the ports are getting submerged, right, at all the levels, there is no problem of clogging or damage by that debris. Now we are going to have the two types of towers, right? With two types of intake towers. One is a dry intake tower and one is wet intake tower. Now we will see what is dry intake tower. Okay, now the water is directly drawn into the withdrawal conduit through the gated entry ports. Here we are going to allow the water directly through the entry ports. It has no water inside the tower if the gates are closed, right? Now if the gates are completely closed over here, right? Now if this is your gate, as you can see that it is going to have the two entry ports, right? If this particular gate is closed, there will be no water inside this particular conduit. So that is the reason why we call it as a dry intake tower. If we close it, there will be no water in the conduit, and thus we can control, we can have say we can have the cleaning also. So this is what your dry intake tower is. Okay, when the entry ports are closed, the dry intake tower will be subjected to the additional bound forces. Okay, hence it must be heavier construction than in case of the wet tower. They are useful, right? That can be hence it must be heavier in the construction than the wet intake tower. So here what is going to happen in your case of a dry intake tower is, right, here it is going to have the gates and these are your entry ports of water. Right. If you are going to close it now, and water will be getting entered into your intake structure, and hence you can have the cleaning, maintenance, and all these things you can do it over here. So this is what your gate is, and this is your port is, right? So this is your level, reservoir level, roof truss. So this is how the water is going to be entered with the conduit. Okay. Now we will see what is wet intake towers. It consists of a concrete circular shell. Now we will see what is your wet intake structure. Here you can see that all the time the water will be maintained inside your conduit. So we will see what is one by one, what is wet intake towers. Okay. Now it consists of concrete circular shell filled with water up to the reservoir level and has a vertical inside shaft which is connected to the withdrawal pipe. Right. So here we can see that there is one more port is there beyond these particular gates. If I open these gates, see here, all the time the water will be there inside this particular area. Here also the gates are always, it is these ports are open, right? We call it as an entry ports. These ports will be already always, it is going to be open. And then the water entry is going to be controlled over here with this help of the gates. Here, these are hydraulically, it is going to be moved with help of these particular gates. Okay, now it is going to be mounted with the shaft. Okay, the withdrawal pipe may lie over the bed of the river or maybe in the form of tunnel. Okay, so you have seen that. Openings are made in the outer concrete shell as well, right, inside the shaft. See here, it is made your entry port, so it is like your well, right? So it is going to be the entry of water is controlled by these gates, which is mounted on a shaft. Okay, next is openings are made in the outer circular concrete shell, right? As I have told, gates are usually placed on the shaft, right, which is going to be mounted on the shaft so as to control the flow of water into the shaft with the having the withdrawal conduit. With help of this, right, these gates, you are going to maintain the water level inside the conduit, right? So this is how, this is your withdrawal conduit. If you open these particular gates, then only the water will enter into this withdrawal conduit. Okay, now what are, we will see, is it a dry and wet intake structure is clear? Yes, dry and wet intake structure, is it clear? Is it clear to all? My voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is
Yes,
it
sir.
clear? What is a dry and wet intake structure? Is it clear to
Yes,
all?
sir. Yes,
Okay.
sir.
I'll go ahead then. I'll go ahead then. So this is regarding dry and wet intake structure. Dry, it means, right, this particular diagram you need to remember, in the dry intake structure, the entry of water will be completely depend on these gates, right? If you open, then only the water will enter. If you close, the water will not be there. But in case of wet intake structure, it will be here. We are going to have the well. In this particular well, the water will be continuously, it will be there, and the entry of the water will be completely depend upon this gates, which is connected to the shaft. Okay, so it is completely dependent upon that. Okay, now medium size river intake structure, right? We will see what are medium size river intake structures are. Okay, now they are generally constructed for withdrawing the water from, right, from the rivers, right? They can be classified into two types, that is a twin well type of intake structure and the single well type of intake structure. Okay, now what is a twin well type of one intake structure? So here one well, here one well, right? Here this is what the single well. Only one well is there. That is the reason why we call it as a single well. And here there are two wells. Here one well and here one well. So that is the reason why we call it as a twin well type of intake structure. Okay, now we will see what is the twin well type of intake structure. They are constructed on almost all types of river, right? Where the water hugs the river bank. Okay, so here the typical river intake is going to have the three components. One is inlet wall, one is inlet pipe, and one is jack well. Okay, so here we will see what is here the intake well, and here this is what jack well. So this is intake well, and this is what your jack well. Okay, so inlet well, jack well, and inlet pipe. So inlet pipe is this particular, we call it as an inlet pipe. Okay, so this we call it as an inlet well, jack well, and this is called, we call it as an inlet pipe. Okay, so now inlet well is usually circular in cross section, right? It is going to be made up of either masonry or either concrete, right? Now inlet pipe connects the inlet well with the help of jack well, right? The inlet pipe, this is what I have told, this is what inlet pipe, right? It is going to connect the inlet well and the jack well. Okay, and the inlet pipe connects the jack well in the with having the diameter of around 45 centimeter. This diameter will be around 45 centimeter. The diameter of this pipe will be around 45 centimeter. Okay, and it is going to be laid at a slope of around 1 in 100, and the flow velocity that we are going to maintain is 1.2 meter per second. The water entering the jack well, it is going to be lifted, and it is going to be it is going to be lifted with the help of pump. So here again I have told that here the bar screen will be there. From this bar screen, the larger floating elements, it is going to be removed, right? And then the water is going to enter into your jack well, right? Here there is, we are going to have one more fine screen which is going to remove the your very fine particles, and then the water is going to enter into the jack well with the help of the inlet pipe. And here we are going to have the strainer, right? Here it is, we call it as an, like in our tanks and all, we are having one ball valve, right? We are having one ball valve from your suction pipe end. So it is going to remove the finer particles, and then we are going to take it with the help of pump, and directly we are going to take it to the treatment plant. So intake structure, it should be very it should be very near to your source of water body. It is not that always the treatment plant will be very near to your intake structure. Okay, it might be away from your treatment plant, might be away from your intake structures. Okay, so this is what the twin well intake structure is. Now we will see what is a single well intake structure. So here we are going to have only one well, right? So here we are only going to have one well. So that is the reason why we call it as a single well of an intake structure, right? So here no inlet well, right? And inlet pipe in this type of river structure, as you can see that no, there is no inlet well, and the inlet pipe will be there. The opening or ports fitted with the bar screen are provided at the jack well. So here these are your inlet ports, the different water level. This is high flood level, this is normal water level and minimum water level. So at all the levels we are going to have these particular ports. It is going to be fitted with the screen so that the larger floating element should not enter into your water body. Okay, now then the sediment entering will be less, and since the clear water will enter and it is going to be taken, and then silt entering into the jackwell will partly settle down at the bottom of the silt, right? And or may be lifted up with the pumped water, since the pump can easily lift the sedimented water also. So as I have told, right, sometimes the your suspended very finer suspended particle will enter, and it may enter into your it will enter into your treatment plant. So here we are going to have the different ports at a different level so that the water will be received at all the levels. Strainer is going to be fixed. It is going to remove some of the finer suspended particle, but there is a possibility of fine suspended particle they may enter into your water treatment plant, and it can pass through the your pump also. So this is how the single and different types of the intake structure we are going to have in our next class. We will be studying regarding canal intake with the sluice, with the dams, right? We are going to see all these different types of the intake structure in our next class. So as today we have finished, right? Today we have finished, say, your dry intake structure, wet intake structure, right? And then we have seen your single well and double well, the river intake structure. Okay, so this is what we have studied in our today's class. What is intake structure? What are the site selection for the intake structure? How the intake, what are the different types of intake structure that we are dry and wet intake structure, that is submerged intake structure. And then we have studied the river intake. In river intake, we are going to have two types. One is single well and one is twin well. So this is what we have studied in our today's class. Do you have any doubt? Yes, do you have any doubt?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay, so again we will meet for the surveying class at 1:30, right? We will meet for the surveying class at 1:30. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. It seems there are no doubts. Okay, so we will meet for the survey class at 1:30 p.m. Okay, thank you, and please type your attendance right in your text box. Type it in chat box. You can type your USN name and USNs. Yes, we are going to end the session. I hope that everyone has given their attendance. Okay, we will end the class and we will meet at 1:30 p.m. Thank you.